Oh, okay. Yeah, we'll see. Was it was this camera. Camera, yeah, camera was Fosse, yeah, sorry, yeah. Can you camera and pause? This is Gene, right? Exposure. Yeah, that. But what is this? Gene is his name.
Yes, Gene,
And
yeah. Exposure. Or
He told me that he had a he told me that he told me that he had bad writing.
Oh, bad. Oh,
Did
yeah.
you know? Did you have you ever seen his writing?
Not all of it. I
Have
can't
you ever seen his writing?
Yeah, it's bad.
Oh.
Very bad. Very bad.
It's a good thing that he bought it. That he it's a good thing that he bought it. It's because between plant. Plant. Yeah, friend and camera.
Yeah,
Is that
keep me busy.
yeah.
Keep me busy thinking.
Yeah. So
Let's see. Well, okay. Okay,
this is a nice camera.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, so I don't know. Let me see.
I've been busy. I got to the computer. that it's exactly like mine, brother. Yeah, and you gave me
a cartridge.
Yeah. And I still just a little bit.
Me in here.
Yeah, and then I will, and then I think two black and, I think it's magenta, two, and then I'll bring them over here, and we'll see, but, you had a video.
Yeah.
And that was good.
The video was good.
Yeah, well.
Yeah. Yeah, we show it.
Yeah, and so according to the video, take the tape off.
Stop leaking.
I haven't. Can we see it again?
Yeah. If I just made it. I don't remember how I got it. There's my scooter. Oh, they got the wrong one.
Tell me about that.
Tell you about that?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to fix that up for our church, for a handicap, so they can get into church.
You gave them one before.
They need to know.
And so, they call you on the phone?
No. A church up on Houghton has a big flea market once a year. And my sister goes to that church. And she saw that. So she told me, she said, they got one there. Why don't you go up and see if you want to fix that up for our church? So I said, yeah. So I went up there. So then I says, can you deliver it? And they said, oh, yeah. So they delivered. That saved me from lifting it into the car. My back, I can't do that kind of work anymore.
So, how much was it?
How much was it?
Yeah.
$50.
This guy, he wanted to name this guy.
I don't know. He belongs to that church. People bought all kinds of stuff. Tables, couches, chairs, and they couldn't deliver it. So this guy has this trailer that tips and everything, and he's got another fellow that helps him. And he's hurt his foot, so he can't do it today. But he had some light stuff to deliver, so he delivered my scooter because he could handle that. So he belongs to that church, this guy. I don't know what his name is.
He hurt his foot?
His helper hurt his foot. This man's helper. There's another man that goes with him, but he hurt his foot.
No, but he has the left foot.
Yeah.
Versus the right.
Yeah.
Left. Last foot. Okay. Versus.
Oh, he has some. Oh, maybe this is the guy that hurt his foot. I don't know. He had a different sand.
Yeah, he had. This is.
I didn't pay any attention.
Oh, yes.
Now that I'm retired, Medicare is on my to-do list. And with all the recent changes in healthcare, it's
refilling this cartridge.
The inside of the cartridge, we have the air vent, the full spout, and an area between two thin plastic membranes where the ink is stored.
Make it. You can't see it. You can't see it.
Oh no. Not a very good picture.
No.
Very good. The light?
No.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Turn upside down. You suck some air out of it. And turn right side up. And allow the pressure to equalize itself, injecting ink into the cartridge.
Simmer. Yeah, simmer.
It's probably about full. Always let the pressure equalize before you remove it. These caps will equalize the pressure.
Oh.
Which is something you should usually do before installing your printer. So you may wish to clean this up.
This is different.
Yeah, this is different. And you can clean it, I guess.
Refilling this cartridge.
In the inside of the cartridge, we have the air vent, the full spout, and an area between two thin plastic membranes where the ink is stored.
Turn upside down. You suck some air out of it. And turn right side up.
And allow the pressure to equalize itself, injecting ink into the cartridge. It's probably about full. Always let the pressure equalize before you remove it.
These caps will equalize the pressure, which is something you should usually do before installing your printer. So you may wish to clean this up.
Um,
It's different though.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good point. I don't remember what it was. I have no idea.
I do.
You do?
Yeah, I do.
Okay. Maybe you can find it. I don't know.
Are you Netcare, is that your name? Netcare, is that your name? Netcare.
Oh, yes. Yeah, my mom for that.
Let's see. What I wanted to do was first of all. Room might work.
While we're fooling around here, they can be charging up. That's all I'm going to do. I thought while you was working with that, I could plug that in. That's all I wanted to do.
Oh, okay.
I'm not going to do it.
Okay, how do you kill on the host? The host is done. Oh. Oh, yeah, okay. How did you get that?
You have to hold it back. It won't work that way. You've got to get it back here. Okay. It's not working out. You completely dead move. Yeah, it would work. It would work when it's showing you right there. I won't do it now. Completely bad now. There's a light when you get it down there like that, and it's white. Something in that hinge, the wire is worn out. Everything's working except the screen don't light up.
So then we give you some stuff for the camera. And you got the cords. Yeah, I got the cords on. And you was the first time you've done. Is this the first time you've done this?
I've had it all week. I had it for a week.
Oh.
And I took it back Sunday to him.
Oh.
And I told him what the situation was. And he said, hey, look, you take it, you can have it, because he says, I bought it at a thrift store or someplace. Garage sale or something. He used it. It worked. Then all of a sudden it quit working. Well, after so many times working that wire, it breaks. So whoever had it probably used it a lot. And they opened it up, closed it up, opened up, opened up, opened up, and that broke that wire. See? I mean, it held while he had it. He used it. And he took some movies or some videos with it, and then it got all white, like I showed you when I first turned it on. But it was white all the time. But I could take and I could see, if I hold it on an angle, I could just see a little bit of writing in it.
Hey! When are you going to pick up your speaker?
Yeah, that was done the next day that you brought it here. And I was waiting to see how long it would be before you.
Hey, it is.
It's fixed.
Boy, it's been nice to put it. Now we're you the big bucks, huh?
I was wondering how long it was going to be before.
Well, I was trying to see if I could save up enough money to pay my bill.
Well, you're going to have to work the rest of your life.
Who's this stranger here, you been? How you doing? Okay?
Fine.
Yeah, that's great. He's got his Pennsylvania cap on. Mm-hmm. What's the big bucks I owe you? Was it just one wire? You know what? You know why I wanted to fix that speaker? Now, this sounds kind of nuts, maybe, but whenever, Keller moved out lately, you knew he moved out, didn't you? He lived down on 3? Oh, okay, I thought you knew him. But anyway, he had the old radio and player that plays 33 and a third and all that he got off of Bob Hughes when Bob sold stuff. Well, Bob Hughes died the other day, and so I thought I got that off of Keller, so I thought I'd kind of have a little keepsake there. Old Bob Hughes. Because I liked old Bob. He's a good old boy. He was 99. I saw him haul this guy out down here a while ago. They didn't know whether he was with us yet or not. 619, I forget his name. Right there on the condition you go in the gate.
Oh, yeah.
Now that's who they said it was. I'm repeating.
They weren't going. They were going pretty fast.
Well, I'm just telling you what I heard, but could be because he wasn't in good shape. I know that he had problems before. We're doing pretty good. We're still around.
So far. The red wave may be here all morning.
Well, you know where they were at yesterday, I think it was, and I was out driving around. I'm telling you where they were parked in front of, and I hope, I don't know, I never knew anything was wrong. You know Ashby that used to be our guard?
Yeah.
You knew him, didn't you?
Yeah.
He's a good guy, I think. He was a hell of a good old boy. They were right in front of his place.
Mm-hmm.
Ambulance and the fire truck.
Mm-hmm.
But I never knew, had heard either one of them being anything wrong with him. Of course, we don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But I just hadn't heard no more on it, but I saw that. I thought, oh, God. I hate to see him leave the guard house down there. I always liked him to come in. He's always friendly and nice. Am I bothering your operation here? I don't want to bother you.
Yeah, I'm teaching him.
Oh, I'm sorry. He's trying to learn something. I'm bothering you.
Yeah.
See you later. Thank you, Tommy. That sounds good. Yep, that's good. Thanks again, Tom.
Okay.
ThinkProducts.com has now released the ultimate refill kit.
So, heat on this aluminum. See what which one it was that I got. I don't remember which one it was.
Yeah, does it seem like you're always running out of printer ink? Don't you hate it when you see that low ink symbol? It means you have to go out and buy another expensive ink cartridge. But wait, before you took that.
Okay. You said you had this for a week, but you have not. we have not been interested, not interested, that's wrong, wrong word. That's the wrong word. We didn't.
Two different things. Taking the pictures and know what button does what. Yeah. I'm not interested. Right. But the thing that does not work, I'm interested.
Oh.
Two things.
I see.
See? Yeah. Taking pictures and getting it just right, so you fool around, you get, I am blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
But if it didn't work, then I get in there, I'll find out why it didn't work.
Oh,
see?
I see.
I'm not interested in taking pictures. I'm not interested in whether this button does that or this, that. I don't care.
Yeah.
The camera I got, all I have to do is push the button and it takes a picture and fine. I got a picture, and I don't care what it's blurry, in focus, out of focus, got blues where the gray should be. I don't care.
Yeah, I think.
You know. So that's what these buttons do. You can get the lightness, you get automatic focus or manual focus, all of that stuff. But I don't know what button does what. When the button don't work, then I'm interested. And the button don't work.
I see. Well,
especially when you've been running, it says, "Hey, you take it and see if you can play with it. It's fine."
So
I went through every button, I've done everything, I went on the internet, on Google, everything on Google, I went in on the manual, all through the manual, I've done everything.
Oh.
And the next thing to do is to take it apart. I haven't figured out how to take it apart yet. So that's my next.
You're going to take it apart?
I'm going to take it apart.
Well,
it's really not any good the way it is, and I feel that the problem is in the hinge, and there's a wire in there. I found that on Google. I went in there and it says the viewfinder don't work on the Samsung and the model number, and then it showed where the hinge, the wire can break. It showed that, but didn't show how to take it apart.
You've never done this. You have never done this. Never.
On a camcorder. I've taken a lot of other stuff apart. I've taken camera.
Camera?
Oh, I've taken movie camera. I've had this one all apart. And I put it back together.
So, we have this apart. It's the only one you had.
Well, I think one time was a lot. I had a couple of other ones that I took apart, put back together.
Well, so you took it all apart. And you put it back together. Why did you take it apart?
Because you've got to have more voltage to make it work than what the batteries put out.
But can I, beside this, beside, besides this, which none of work, this
won't work with two brand new batteries in there. It won't work. It's got to take more. There's the batteries I use, and then I have here it is.
I made a thing.
See, I made a thing that I can increase the voltage. And then I have more voltage. This is 4 volts. These two batteries in here is only 3.5 volts. And a volt and a half is 3 volts. That's only 3 volts to live. So I put this thing in and hook this thing up and it would work. And that's 4 volts. So that means that there's something on the printed circuit board, one of the parts in there is defective.
Where did you get this?
I made it.
Yeah, but okay, so I'm going like this. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And where are this?
That hooks under here.
And where is this? This.
That hooks under here.
Oh. And then what?
Then it worked. Then the camera would work. But it wouldn't work for very long. Because this battery would run down in a hurry. That would run down to 3 volts and it wouldn't work.
And
Hello.
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 Good morning. This is Stephen Durham calling for the Fidel Order of Police, Arizona State Lodge. Sir, the reason for my call, the state FOP, they just kicked off their fund drive and is a big fundraiser for residents.
So, you put this out and put it just a regular ballot, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it wouldn't work. When did that happen? When did that happen?
A year or two ago.
You mean, it worked and then it quit working?
Yeah. I would put new batteries in and it would work maybe for 10, 15 minutes. It wouldn't work anymore. So then I put another brand new batteries in. It'll work for 10 minutes. It would just go dead. Nothing would work. Put new batteries in, and it would work for 10 minutes. So I'm saying that there's a heavy draw that draws those batteries down, but I wanted to prove to myself that that's what it was. So I rigged this up and have a battery that's more, and then this would work maybe for half hour or hour. So that proved my point. So there's something in on that printed circuit board, one of those little parts that you can't buy, or I don't know which one it is.
I'm sorry. You were saying, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I forgot what I said.
And you took it all apart.
Yeah, I took it all apart.
And you say you put the battery in and would work for 15 minutes and didn't work anymore.
Of course, if you leave it just set for a little bit, the batteries kind of would revive themselves, and then you would turn it on and it would come on and right off.
You see, this is the problem I have with this this is the problem I have with with the new versus the old. Like the old, I had it. I think there wasn't any batteries. It wasn't a battery. It was just, and the all of a sudden, I had a camera, and it both said batteries. It was just a camera, period. Now you can't buy it because you have to put in batteries, right? I mean, is there any way all of this has to have a battery, but I don't think my old camera was 1980 something. It's just a camera, batteries. I mean, no batteries. Just understand me. Mm-hmm. And the picture worked fine.
Mm-hmm.
Then I had a video,
mm-hmm.
but it was this bit,
mm-hmm.
but it was still good to look at the thing, and there was a big battery.
Mm-hmm.
I never had a problem.
Mm-hmm.
And then now I got one, two, three, one, two, three, four, camera that broke it.
Mm-hmm.
Broke, and I'm trying to figure out how to figure out so well, so you've got two where you've taken apart.
Mm-hmm.
And now you go to three. Well,
that's going to be a little more complicated getting that one apart. I looked it over. I've taken the screws out, and I tried to break it loose, but so I put the screws, back in. I put the screws back in. I had these screws out, and whatever other screws I could see, and I was trying to take it apart. It's got a split right there, so I figured that side can go. And I couldn't. I got to research it a little bit more.
And how about this?
That stays on this here.
there's a hole on the inside. So you have to take this side off first before you can do anything with that side.
When are you going, I guess, whenever.
Yeah, it's one of those things that it's not important. I don't need it, so. So other things can be more important. Fix that scooter up for the church is probably my first priority.
Right.
And then going to my daughters for Thanksgiving is second priority. Get something good to eat. No batteries are full. Where'd you get that? I got it where you share. So those are good batteries. They won't work in there. Let's see what I have here. Let's see. The battery must have run down, just sitting there. The battery probably not enough juice into it. Was this, was that the thing that you would always tell me about?
Yeah.
I got it on here.
It's just one of the things that I told you about.
Yeah. And I had a magazine that that was talking about that, so I copied the disc. And so I just put it on here. I was having trouble getting the English. I wanted to be in China. Chinese. It comes up by itself. That's it right there. Here's my Windows 7 down here. Is that what you get? Is that the way yours look?
Well, it's different.
It's different.
This,
but it's the same program.
The same program.
And you see, I'm just got the Chinese here. And then if I go find something else, and there it says quit. See, some. That don't have no English. There we got some English. That's been my problem. And we go down here and try to go into my system settings here. And then I go into language support. Didn't have fun. I'm sorry to learn. There's my English. They said to put it at the top. Oh. It's not installed completely. Most of the media estimate. This is the new version. You might have the other. Do you have 11 or 12 new version? I don't know. This is 13. This is the new version. You need to authenticate. So I got to work on that a little more. Because I don't know what's going to happen when we run out of Windows 7. They're going to have it for quite a while, but Windows 8 isn't going over very good.
Oh, really?
Yeah. People don't like it.
Uh-huh.
That's why I brought, when I saw this, that's why that article was in there, because they were saying the same thing. They said they don't know what's going to happen with Microsoft, because Windows 8 isn't doing what they was hoping it would do. So they were talking about this, and they said to download that and to try it out. So that's what I was doing. And not, so far, not too impressed with it yet. But I get it working like it's supposed to work. But it might be. And if we don't have 7, that's something like this is the only thing we got left.
What?
If Windows 7 isn't good enough, then we're going to have to go to some program like this. As we upgrade throughout the lifetime, things don't stay the same. Just like Windows 98, we outgrew that. And Vista, we outgrew that. We got Windows XP, we outgrew that. Now we're in Windows 7. And when we outgrow that, 8 can't replace it because 8 isn't as good as Windows 7. So we have to have some kind of a program up here that will meet our needs into all the newer things that's been invented and upgraded. Everything is being upgraded, made a little bit better, a little bit faster. And so we're going to have programs that will take care of it. At my age, I'm not too much worried about it. But my grandkids and great grandkids, I don't know what. Even the iPods are going to be outdated. Something else will be coming. Voice over text is coming in, like in the automobiles. You can say, start the car. The car will start up. They also got it so that by voice commands, turn left, and the thing to turn left, turn right, the thing to turn right. But they have to be careful of that kind of a command. Somebody says, like, the woman in the back is doing the back seat driving, turn left, and you're supposed to turn right.
Bang!
Well, very good. I'm surprised you can't be going to. I'm surprised you can't be going to. You're surprised you're right. You're going to. That's the name of the program.
Oh, is that the name of it?
Yeah.
Ubuntu.
Yeah, Ubuntu. Yeah.
I never knew how to pronounce it.
Yeah, Ubuntu. I always thought that you were into Microsoft.
Mm-hmm. Well, I want to a certain point, but you see, the Windows XP, you can't get any upgrading to it. Some of the programs they write now won't work on Windows XP. You gotta have Windows 7. Also, they're going to 64-bit instead of 32-bit. Windows XP, most of it is 32-bit. Windows 7, most of it is 64-bit. But it will work on 32 too.
Some things and sometimes no.
Mm-hmm. If the program is strictly 64, then that's it. But if it's 64 and 32, then it'll work on both. So, we'll be working with different kinds of programs. Can't get out of it. Because I don't have that icon way up in the corner there, and this one I just clicked on it, and it's not doing anything. I knew I had that one.
Yeah.
And all other things failed.
Okay. Okay. I guess we'll see you next week.
Okay. All right. Oh, I got into YouTube when I was looking for stuff taking that apart, and I ran across the
the stuff that you put in.
What do you mean?
The videos that you put in the YouTube. We got 11, 12, or 13, you know. Could you see the video? The videos that you've been taking here is in the YouTube.
What? You. I don't understand.
Those pictures, those things over there, did you upload those to YouTube?
Yeah.
That's what I saw.
You saw it?
I saw
it. Oh, what, how come?
Well, I was looking for stuff for this, and I just ran across it.
Oh, really?
There it was. Hey, there I am. Hi.
Yeah, I got...
Oh, yeah, there's a whole bunch of...
All kinds of things.
Is in there, yeah.
I got... I got all kinds of things.
For anybody that didn't know it, looking at it wouldn't know what it was all about. So you would need to have some kind of a caption.
No, I have like, for example, when we're working on print, like I've put print, or when we're working on cameras, I'm looking at camera. Anything. I don't just put numbers. I put down Tom, and I put the date, and then I put down something to do with it, something to do. Sometimes it could be about like this, but I say looking at looking at mouse,
mm-hmm.
You know, I'll put that on. So every time I have.
Mm. Yeah, see, I didn't see that part. I don't know, because I just got into it. I saw Tom, 11, 12, and something else. I forgot what it was. that was all. A whole bunch of them.
A whole bunch of them. That's good. I mean, I'm glad very hard for me to say, but I take everything and I keep, because somebody else might, and also I need to study it.
Mm-hmm.
And
that's right.
Study it, and also other things, maybe shown on the maybe doctors,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Or maybe somebody would need help.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. like have all the like when we put the hand,
yeah.
Hand, or we do this,
right.
Yeah. Like this, this,
yeah.
This.
The hand, the signature, put your hand.
Yeah, and this, and I got it all written. Yeah, and then video. And some, I think it will help many people. Many people.
That's, they say, oh, look at that. We'll make one of those.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. Thank you.